to go on day 69's pretty cool.
Yeah, but
of all days, I think that's an awesome one to go.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
But I mean, yeah, I totally would have liked to say goodbye to those dudes.
You'll get a chance to say hello to them all over again on Friday.
Yeah.
let's see what happened when the other four realised that you'd gone.
No, it's that Stu that's gone. He was saying Stuart.
Is he won it?
No fucking way.
Has he won it?
Maybe he has, that would be brilliant.
He's won it.
The door opened.
But if he's gone, then he's gone.
The door opened.
He's won it.
That would be brilliant. Let's hope he hasn't gone just like that without saying goodbye, though.
Well, we're going to see him tomorrow anyway. Or Friday.
No, but maybe he's won.
He's won it. That's them shouting, he's won it.
No, he was shouting Stuart.
Oh, he was!
No, it was Stuart.
No, they were shouting Stuart.
He's won it.
He must have, and he deserves it.
Oh my God!
Oh my God! And do you know what's cute? They're really happy for you. Oh, are you feeling a bit sad?
It's not sad. I can't tell you how stunned.
I know. I'll carry on.
Beyond stunned.
I'll soldier on. Now, listen. First off, I just want to say, let's give them a big round of applause because they're full 10 weeks. You didn't get one single nomination. Now you can clap. Very, very good. Now, Victor and Jason used to have their jungle cat chats in the bedroom all the time. And they decided that you just sat on the fence, basically, and tried not to offend anyone. And that was how you didn't pick up the nominations. Did you go in there with a sort of game plan to sort of get underneath and escape everybody, or...?
Well, like, sort of just in life generally, I don't ever...
Conflict.
Yeah. I mean, completely just... My life just seems to not generate it. And I kind of thought a lot of the sort of conflicts and things that were going on in there were about reasons that it's just pointless. I mean, I'm not addicted to cigarettes or anything, so if they go, it's not a problem for me. And I don't know, things like that, that just... it kind of just didn't matter enough.
Yeah, to get involved in it.
Yeah,
I understand. I also want to thank you because I love a love story.
Right.
And you had one, so thank you. We were all gripped. She's not here right now. She's not in this room, so you can be honest. Do you love her?
Yeah, I'll save that. That's
just, tell mummy.
Sorry, it's not for your ears, guys.
But, oh, so that's a maybe.
Well, it's just, stuff Stuart. For us too.
I feel like Big Brother when she said sit when you were dressed up as your cat, but I've got to say stop swinging.
Sorry.
Now, listen, you started out not wanting to have a public relationship, and that was very clear and completely understandable because you just didn't want to sort of conduct a relationship on television. But then you gave in, and it did feel like you kind of just gave in. Now, why?
I mean, I don't know. It's so difficult. It's easy to forget as well where you are.
Yeah.
So that kind of comes into play, just that, I don't know, you just kind of let go and things and just kind of do what you want to do almost.
I mean, after 4 weeks, it's hard to kind of keep up.
Yeah.
Isn't it? All the time, being aware of the cameras.
And when you want to, you want to be a certain way, you just can't. I don't know, it's just pretty difficult.
You couldn't help yourself.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, who do you think wore the trousers in your relationship?
Need you even ask that question?
I thought you might say that. Have a look.
Who's the best girlfriend in the world, Stu?
Sure.
That's a good answer.
When his missus gets involved, he loses all his identity.
She wears a fucking trousers, doesn't she?
She may be the face I can't forget.
I think you need to give me a big cuddle right now.
I don't know where you're going to go now, but they ain't far.
Sure, I thought you were going to help me with these dishes.
I'll dry them and put them away.
Yeah, that's what you will do.
So don't even try to say that you're sleepy today.
Help now, Gerald, please.
Well, you're not going on a skiing holiday, so you can get that one out of your head.
Just make sure you're facing opposite direction.
We will be.
Hope that wish was for me.
No.
Oh, Stu!
Oh, guys.
It's
what
different
is going
wearing
on?
The trousers and just ordering somebody around and you being the lapdog.
Are you still going to go in the jacuzzi? Shall I answer your question for you? Yes, you are.
Come on.
Oh, Stu. Every time. Of my dreams.
as for you, when are you going to start wearing the trousers in your relationship?
There might not be any cuddling going on, Mish.
They are the first strong words I have ever heard come out of Stuart's mouth.
I know.
Can't believe that you're choosing shower over cuddles.
It's like they've been married for 20 years, the way they sleep to each other.
Eh, like make it used to this, it's tough, man.
I think that the public evicted Michelle because she just came across as being very jealous and very possessive. Now, is that how it felt to you?
No, not at all. I mean, you are in there for sort of 24 hours a day, and so, I don't know, stuff like that's easily sort of pickable upon.
Right.
And so, I don't know, it's cool.
But I thought, in a sense, because you were in such a small enclosure, she didn't have any reason to be jealous or possessive because there was nowhere for you to go.
Yeah. It's a mystery.
Anyway, listen, after 8 weeks, you did eventually succumb to her wishes underneath the table. Why then? Because you really didn't seem to want to that night either, but you just gave in.
Don't know, I mean...
Lust.
Yeah.
I know, your mum's sitting around you. Sorry, Mum. Sorry, Dad. So, listen, what did happen under the table?
Not saying a word.
You did hear quite a lot.
Oh no, please, please don't make me listen to anything.
No, we don't need to show it to you. We all heard it.
Okay.
We all heard it. It's absolutely fine.
That's pretty embarrassing.
Now listen, you did ask her not to say anything. You did ask her not to say anything, but in true girly fashion, we literally can't keep it to ourselves. She did have to tell Shell and Nadia the next day in the snug. But she did use a code, which was absolutely caca.
Oh, I can't believe this.
Absolutely caca code, using the word swallow and tool. Any ideas what she might have been talking about?
No idea.
No, I didn't think you said.
No.
Anyway, Michelle's been all over the papers since she's been evicted. Dreamed about my romps with Stu.